Hello students, today we will learn how to derive a relationship in the case of a potentiometer where we are going to compare the EMF of two cells. In the video we saw that practically how we can compare that of a Leclanché cell and a Daniell cell. The same circuit is here. This is the potentiometer and I have taken with the 4 meter bridge. So here it starts 0 and it goes to 100 and it is here 200 and it is here 300 and it is here 400 centimeter, right? So the primary circuit consists of a battery. Usually we offer close to 9 volt for proper functioning. A minimum of 9 volt battery is connected here, and then from positive I have connected to a key, and positive to negative of an ammeter, then positive and rheostat. I told you rheostat is a variable resistance so that I can adjust this jockey here and see that I fix a particular amount for the particular set of value which I am going to take the current value. Fine. So this completes the primary circuit. This is the primary circuit for the thing to function. Fine. Now you come to the other part of it. The same point A and this point end point is B. So A to B, the circuit is complete. Now from the point, same point A, I connect two cells. Okay. I'm going to connect here two cells whose EMF which I have to calculate. Yeah, so let me make it a little smaller. So two cells, this is epsilon 1, that is one cell, and I'm going to connect another cell and that is going to be epsilon 2, right? Epsilon 1 and epsilon 2, these are the two cells whose EMF I'm going to compare, right? So what is that basically? Epsilon 1 upon epsilon 2, we have to now find out. Fine. Now this is a two-way key. 1, 2. I can even simplify it further for you. Fine. I can make this as 1, right? And I can make this as 2. Fine. So what I'm going to do is 1 is with the epsilon 1, cell 1, and 2 is epsilon 2, that is cell 2, and 3 is the center point of a two-way key. Fine. From that third point, the middle point, it go to your resistance box and to your galvanometer and to the jockey. Similar to meter bridge, but something different also, right? Jockey is the contact on the wire, and galvanometer, we connect the resistance box so that the galvanometer coil will not get damaged due to excess current or any other reason, so that to safeguard that, we have a resistance box. Now, I am going to compare the EMF, I say. Now, I want to put a statement that EMF is proportional to length. Now, we should find out how EMF is proportional to length. That means the current which is flowing through is proportional to length. Yes, some factors has to remain constant. Now, epsilon, I can simply say from Ohm's law, V is equal to R into I. In this particular thing which we are doing in the potentiometer, we keep a constant current. We are going to make the current constant. That means for 1 ampere current, I take two sets of value. I am going to find the balancing length. I connect point 1 and 3 so that cell 1 will come into the circuit. Right, when cell 1 is coming to the circuit, I current will flow through the galvanometer and I move it on this and I have to find the balancing length, let us say L1. And second, then I connect the point 2 and 3 together and again I find what is the balancing length, and that is L2. But for the same current, I am fixing the same current. So when current is constant, that means it is going to remain constant, V will be proportional to R. Okay, now we will say what is R. R is actually rho L upon A. rho L upon A, right? Rho is that of the resistivity of the wire which we have taken, and area of cross section of the wire which you have taken, all of constants. So naturally you will find that R is proportional to L. So watch carefully here. V is proportional to L. R, generally we can say EMF is proportional to L because R is proportional to L. So this comes from this equation. Okay, I have taken Ohm's law and I have taken current being constant, and then R is rho upon L upon A. Rho, resistivity of the wire, area, thickness of the wire, they remain constant. So R is proportional to L, which means that V is proportional to L. And for practical purposes, simply we can say epsilon is proportional to L. So that is the basic principle formula which we are going to use. So what I do now, as I said to you before, we bring cell 1 into that thing, circuit. Okay, so epsilon 1 will be proportional to L1. Call this as equation number 1. Now 2 and 3 is connected together, fine. At that time you find out what is the balancing length, and for the second cell epsilon 2, which is equal proportional to L2, equation 2. This is for cell 1 and this is for cell 2. So for these two cells we have done the comparison. Now we got the values L1 and L2. So epsilon 1 upon epsilon 2 is equal to L1 upon L2. So this completes the whole activity of comparison of EMF with using a potentiometer. It's very simple. You read the theoretical part of it and look at the diagram and practical, and you'll be doing practical probably in your session. So then you will understand it much, much better. Thank you so much.